Hello rugged fans, and welcome back to Copenhagen Suborbitals, where we continue working on the world's only crewed crowdfunded space rocket, Spica. So we managed to throw the Supersonic-X Drogue out from the top of the 65 meter tall building next to our workshop. Before the drop, I told the guys that we should expect this design to take a little longer before it opened compared to what we're used to. And I was right about that. Other than that, it opened up beautifully, it seemed stable, and all we can say is about this test is that it got accepted to be tested with a skydiver. So before you go, I'd like to quickly go back in time and give you a production update on another one of our booster recovery contenders, the ribbon Hemisflo design. As you can see now here, I have now sewn three cores together, and even though it is very time consuming and takes a little bit more concentration of the driver behind the needle, I must admit that it is not as difficult as I had feared to make a ribbon parachute. And what did I mean by the concentration, you may ask? Well, I had a little lapse of concentration, and at one point in the beginning of one of the gores, I skipped one of the points where the ribbons connect to the webbing, and I only discovered that at the bottom of the 27 ribbons, and discovered that there wasn't any room to attach the last ribbon. Whoops. But things are moving forward, and I am really looking forward to comparing this parachute with the Supersonic-X design, which is ready and just waiting for its first simple drop tests. So since then, we have also managed to finish the production of the first small-scale prototype of the ribbon Hemisflo parachute and drop that as well from the rooftop. Since this design is meant for high velocities, I honestly was very concerned if it would open up at all during descent and or if it would just fall apart on the way down. The first happened, the second did not. So this means that I still can't rule out this design, and we have to take this contender to Odense Skydiving Center as well to see how it performs during a little more realistic test. Speaking of Odense Skydiving Center, what is even more important is that we have also received the formal approval from the Danish Skydiving Federation to actually perform these tests. We are incredibly grateful for the cooperation that we have with the organization, and that goes for the Federation, but especially of course Odense Skydiving Center. So we really want to say thank you guys, we really appreciate your help. In the next round of the crewed tests with the different drogue parachutes, let's just sum up what we are going to test. For the space capsule, we are going to test the Mark 3.5 balut design, and that looks like a 1.9 meter diameter acorn. And we expect Ahmed to have a speed of about 100 to 115 kilometers per hour with that one. As we have talked about in some of the previous videos we have made, we will try to reuse the speaker booster. To do this, we need to find a way to slow it down enough for the main parachutes to survive. For this role, we have two competing designs for the Drogue parachute. The first design, that is the onion-shaped Supersonic-X. This should bring Ahmed to a speed of around 100 to 120 kilometers per hour. And this is a design that I cheer for because it is by far the easiest to design and build. But we also have what we are now calling the Flying Spaghetti Monster, also known as a ribbon Hemisflo parachute. Since this is a smaller prototype, but more unproven in our test catalog, we are not so sure about the descent speed yet, but we should see something in the order of 120 to 140 kilometers per hour. We may also, quite literally, have a very big surprise for this round of tests, because for the first time in 7 years, we will be jumping a completely homemade main parachute. The main parachutes we used for mains for the next missions were standard round C9s that we modified a bit to fit the mission. You have also more recently seen us test up to 3 so-called ring slot parachutes to get a feeling of working with clustered openings. But now BJ from Bama Shoots is working on a main ring sail parachute for the space capsule. And this is the final design that we expect to use on the space capsule. So just as with the balut that we have somewhere here in the room, things are slowly gravitating towards designs that we can lock down, which is a fantastic feeling. The ring sail will be just over 12 meters in diameter or 120 square meters in size. So just to put that in perspective, that is about 3 times the size of the first apartment I moved to when moving away from home. With that size, Ahmed will have a descent speed of about 15 kilometers per hour. So we may have to put into the plan that he should bring a lunchbox with him for all the time he will spend in the sky. So that was just a little update from the Department of Slowly Falling Stuff here in Copenhagen Suborbitals. See you soon again. Thank you.
Copenhagen Suborbitals is a non-profit all-volunteer project. The reason we are getting so close to reaching space on our Spica rocket is because all of our crowdfunding supporters. If you've been following this project and feel passionate about new ways of exploring space and building rockets, you can help us out by going over to our website, www.copsub.com, and becoming a supporter with a small monthly or one-time donation that helps us pay workshop rent and buy materials. And in return, you get all these insider videos on building a space program which you don't really get anywhere else. So on behalf of everybody at Copenhagen Suborbitals, thank you for your support and we'll see you next time.